Well, as you will have seen from the earlier films this year, during 2014 we were quite spoilt for choice, and the first two elements of this film, we see Braunton arriving on the Weymouth Seaside Express, the regular Sunday event, preceded by the diesel unit that we see running down the line to Mudford now, and then after that we're thrilled by the arrival of Tornado the following day on the 25th of August with the Devon Belle, which was running from London through to Devon. Anyway, here comes Braunton. Consistent with our usual routine, we've nipped over to Yeovil Junction station now and caught up again with Braunton. She was detrained at Yeovil Pen Mill and the diesel took the train on to Weymouth, and Braunton has come across to Yeovil Junction to be watered and coaled. But we'll take the opportunity also to look around the station at the other railway activity which is happening whilst Braunton is being attended to. This is the splendid double-sided XBR Southern Region clock, which still functions, at least one face of it does, on the station there. Taking advantage of the arrival of Braunton and the number of spectators that that brings to the station, the railway centre is also operating its push-pull train and its demonstration goods train up and down its short length of line. once again we get the opportunity to see the Railway Centre's wonderful turntable in action, turning Braunton to 360 degrees with seemingly little effort, driven by the vacuum of the locomotive, so the driver simply controlled the operation. There was no force exerted on their part. It's an amazing piece of engineering, which was of course refurbished by the volunteers at the Yeovil Railway Centre.
Thank you. people up now.
Oh, yeah, you can see the pole. Wow, they did fill the pole right up, didn't they? That's a big pile
there. Okay, let's wait to get back outside and get inside. I don't want to go on the door.
Oh, terrific.
We've now come, as if by magic carpet, to Yeovil Penn Mill station to watch Braunton haul her train from Weymouth in the Bristol direction. The following day we were able to see the wonderful sight of Tornado, now resplendent in blue livery, hauling the Devon Belle. Here she comes from Penn Mill through the link line to Yeovil Junction, where she will be with us for probably a quarter of an hour, 20 minutes, and then she'll make her way down to Exeter on the end of her journey. Splendid. I think it needs little commentary from me.
Thank you.
Well, that should have cleaned the ballast on the line to Exeter. And there she goes. Splendid sight. New location for us now, just southwest of Yeovil Junction by Sutton Bingham Reservoir, to watch a recreation of the Atlantic Coast Express drawn by Tangmere. She seemed in good form, and the ducks on the reservoir certainly appeared to enjoy it. The theme of the autumn gala on the West Somerset Railway this year was the 50th anniversary of the closure of the steam shed at Taunton, and a variety of locomotives were in steam, some with their genuine number and some having been subtly renumbered to represent engines that were shedded at the Taunton shed, shed number 83B. But we start by seeing locomotive 1450 pulling the auto coach, which can be driven, of course, from both ends, as you will see when it arrives and then subsequently pulls away again in the Bishop's Lydia direction. Journey to Bishop's Lydia, and hoving into view down the line there is number 4936, Kinlet Hall, but she's one of the engines which has been renumbered for the purpose I described just now, and she is operating as number 4932, Hatherton Hall, which was a Taunton engine. Thank you.
going to get too hot.
It will get hot.
In this brief close-up, we can see how the nameplate has been subtly changed to Hatherton Hall. From a distance, it's unnoticeable. Very good. And she's now about to pull away in the Lydiard direction. Crocombe Heathfield, of course, is a crossover point on the line, which is single track for most of its distance. And here we see, coming from Bishop's Lydiard, the Great Western Small Prairie 5542 with a more significant train of GWR coaches. Thank you. I've now moved to the overbridge, the road overbridge at the other end of Crocombe Heathfield station, which is a familiar vantage point for those who watch these little films. And this time we see the arrival from Minehead of Great Western locomotive, a large prairie locomotive, number 4160. But this is also running as an alternative number. She is numbered for the Gala as 4131. I'm sure these will confuse enthusiasts in the future when they watch films and check people's photographs, but this is number 4160, running is 4131. Once again, we see the changeover procedure as Great Western 57XX class locomotive number 4612 arrives from Bishop's Lydiard and crosses with the train that we've just seen coming from Minehead. Well, the up train is left in the Lydiard direction, and now our Minehead bound train will also leave Crocombe Heathfield station. Thank you. change of scene now. We're on the footbridge at Willetton Station, looking up the line towards Bishop's Lydiard and waiting for the renumbered 4932 to arrive from Bishop's Lydiard. There's the old signal box, which is the original Bristol and Exeter Railway signal box. And here she comes. The single line token is exchanged with the signalman and the locomotive driver as she pulls into the station. Willetton Station is also a crossing point on the line, and this time we've got the benefit of a double header arriving from the Minehead direction. We shall see her come down the slope and into the station. I haven't made a note of the locomotive numbers, but we should see those quite clearly in a moment or two. Well, the locomotive leading is running his number 7820, Dinmore Manor, Great Western Loco, of course. And number 3850 is disguised as number 3863. She's the second of the two locomotives. She, of course, wasn't a named locomotive. And here they come, drifting in. There we have it then, an all too brief visit to this year's Autumn Gala, but certainly on the best day for the weather, because the weather turned rather inclement later on in the weekend. And this brings to an end our little resume of steam operations in Somerset during 2014. All being well, we'll be back again next year for the Spring Gala.